Some of the research that we're doing now at the Beetham Eye Institute involves really exciting and cutting-edge imaging technology to look at the retina in ways that we never could before. And there are a few different ways in which we're doing this. We're looking at ultra-wide-field images, photographs of the retina that take a much broader area of the retina than we've ever done before. To give you some sense of perspective, I think back in the late 1960s, when people were first starting to talk about how to classify diabetic retinopathy, the ability to take retinal photographs out to the periphery of the retina and to then montage, to put together those photographs, took about 12 hours. And now, with a single image, we can get about 82% of the retina in an image that takes less than a quarter of a second to acquire. So it's a huge advance, and Dr. Paulo Silva and Dr. Lloyd Polaiello and myself and others from our group have started to look at changes on the ultra-wide field images to see, now that we can look further out to the edge of the retina than we've done before, does this change the ways in which we can predict the progression of diabetic eye complications? Does it help us understand better who might worsen in their eye disease than we could before? And there's some very interesting data in the studies that Dr. Silva has spearheaded, suggesting that perhaps we can actually use the presence of diabetic lesions or diabetic changes in the retinal periphery to help us better predict who's going to have worsening eye disease over time. In addition to that, my particular group has looked at studies using cross-sectional imaging of the retina to look at the neural retina to see if we can better predict not just who worsens in diabetic retinopathy, but particularly who's going to have better or worse vision over time. And this is crucially important because right now we don't have good ways of predicting which patients with diabetes, which eyes of patients with diabetes will gain vision over time or lose vision over time as we give them the current treatments we have available and as we evaluate new treatments. And so our group at the Joslin has actually recently just published a paper suggesting that perhaps a specific feature of the retinas that we can now evaluate on technology called optical coherence tomography imaging. This is a technique that uses reflection of the light from the retina to look at individual retinal layers. And we've shown that the disorganization of the inner layers of the retina actually is very closely associated with rates of vision loss and gain over time. And so this is a new biomarker that we'll be evaluating in further studies. I think the last imaging technology that we've been evaluating and using to evaluate the eyes of patients with diabetes is a technology called adaptive optic scanning laser ophthalmoscopy. And this is a technique that was proposed in astronomy actually first to correct for wavefront aberrations of light coming through to get sharper and better images. And using the AOSLO technology, we can image a section of retina and get resolution down to about the 2 micron level. Just to give you some perspective on that, the size of the retinal blood vessels, the largest retinal blood vessels in the eye is about 125 microns in diameter. And the diameter of the red blood cells that travel through those blood vessels is about 6 to 8 microns in diameter. So to get resolution down to 2 microns means that we can see the individual red blood cells that flow through the retinal vessels and capillaries. And we can even image structures that are smaller than that in diameter, including the central photoreceptors or light sensing cells in the eye. So this gives us the ability to look for the first time in human eyes in a dynamic fashion at blood flow through the retinal vessels and through changes in those vessels as they occur because of diabetes. And so we're very interested again in using this technology to see if we can explore new and predictive markers of outcomes in patients with diabetes.